wireless charging has been long overdue on iPhones, and with the 2017 generation, Apple has finally adopted it. It's the reason why these iPhones all have glass backs, and we can guess next year's iPhones will be all glass too. We're glad Apple has adopted the Qi wireless charging standard instead of inventing one of their own. We also finally got fast charging capability, but making use of it isn't exactly straightforward because it requires the purchase of an expensive and bulky USB-C MacBook charger. Given the price, it's very ungenerous of Apple not to include a fast charger with the iPhone X. A shame indeed. To add insult to injury, charging the iPhone X either wired or wirelessly via the included 5-watt charger is excruciating slow. Testing bears this out, achieving around 40% after an hour's charge. This is a 2700 mAh we're talking about. It's fine for charging overnight, but don't expect a solid top up when you're in the coffee shop. Initially restricted to 5-watt wireless charging, Apple enabled up to 7.5-watt charging in the subsequent iOS 11.2 software update. The Qi standard supports up to 15 watts of charging. Charging via 7.5-watt wireless in the same test tops the iPhone X up to 46%, an improvement but hardly earth-shattering. We charge our iPad via Apple's 12-watt iPad charger, and using this will take your iPhone X to 72% charge in that same hour. That's much better, but remember, it's an extra purchase, too. If it's max juice in the shortest time year after, then you'll need to invest in a USB-C charger and USB-C to lightning cable. This combination will give you more than a splash and dash and will top your tank up to 79% in that same hour. Given these figures, and what you'd pay for the bulky USB-C charger and cable, we'd recommend using the Apple 12-watt charger for fast wired charging and a 7.5-watt wireless pad for the convenience of wireless charging. A slight downside to the wireless charging implementation with the iPhones is they can be somewhat temperamental, that you take care to put them on the correct spot on the charger and not an inch further. The issue is exacerbated further if you have a thicker than usual wallet style case. It would be nice, especially given the power-sipping AMOLED display, if iOS 11 showed its charging status on screen.